Hello and welcome to Inside the Issues, a show where we answer questions and discuss issues that are important to all of us. I am Jeff Eakins, your superintendent. On today's show, I will give you a quick update about our board reorganization and our newest board members. And we will bring you scenes from the recent National Alliance of Black School Educators Conference hosted right here in Hillsborough County. But before we get to that, I am joined in the studio today by Tammy Derry, our supervisor of middle school math. Hello, Tammy.
Hi.
Thank you for joining me today. We're here on the set at the HCPS studios, and I know that this is almost like a second home to you, right?
Yes, it is almost like a second home because the chair I sit in for our show is right over there.
Well, tell us a little bit about the amazing math show we produce here and how long you've been a part of it.
I've been a part of the show for about 10 years. We've been on a long time, but my brain sitting in the chair next to my co-host Hannah has been for about 10 years, and really, really exciting. Very exciting show to have, and it's really exciting because the students get to be a part of our show.
Okay, tell me a little bit more about that.
Yeah, on Thursday nights, we open up our phone lines about 5:30, and the teachers are there to answer their questions from 5:30 to 6. So they can call in, they have a teacher to help them with their math problems, maybe homework, or it could also even be a problem that they're working on just in the classroom that they need a little extra help on. Mm-hmm. Then at 6 o'clock, we go live, and it is a live TV show, so whatever happens goes right out on air, so we have to be real careful and be really sharp with our math skills. So Hannah and I sit down, we look at the topic for the week, which is typically tied into something that most of the students would be working on at that point in the school year. And then we wait for the callers to call in, because at 6 o'clock, that exciting part really happens, because the students can ask to come on air live with us. Okay. So we call them to the studio, we talk to them, and they can at home hear us and see us do the problems on their television, or maybe a laptop or a computer, because we also stream live on the web. So Hannah's and board and my board is right in front of us. The camera's above us, so when we're working the math problem out, the students are actually seeing it in real time.
Okay, well, do you get a lot of call-ins?
We sure do, and some nights we can't even get them all in, so the teachers in kind of our green room area will actually take the calls for us, and we get as many on air as we can. And a really neat part is that every week we have a special challenge question. Hannah designs those questions around the topic, and then we present it at the beginning of the show. We give them a couple hints throughout the show if we haven't gotten a winner, but we usually get a winner every week. It's really awesome, and the students work probably a much more detailed question than they would get inside their traditional classroom. Okay. So it allows them to think a little bit. And when they call in, they get a prize if they win, and that gets sent out to their school through their math teacher.
Well, thank you for being a part of the show. I mean, obviously it's a great service for our kids across Hillsborough County Public Schools, and the show's been a huge success. So
yes,
that's kudos to you, Tammy.
Well, now, thanks.
Tell me a little bit more about some of the other exciting things that are happening in middle school math right now.
Well, in middle school math right now, we are really that transition for our students to go from elementary school math into high school math. So you'll see that transition when we really look at how do we support the parents through the changes mm-hmm. in mathematics. So in sixth and seventh grade, we really work hard with that to give the parents some opportunities to help their students, one through Math Homework Hotline, but also through some of our parent newsletters we've put out through our district, which are available online for our parents. In addition to that, in middle school math, a really neat thing that we do is we offer algebra to a lot of our students, yeah. And we really give a lot of support to our students. Very proud of those opportunities for kids to excel.
Yeah, well, obviously you do a great job, Tammy, in the role that you play for Hillsborough County Public Schools.
Thank you.
Obviously the Homework Hotline show is a huge hit, and I know you have some important information you want to provide out there about the Homework Hotline show, so why don't you give them some information out there to our audience?
I certainly do, and actually I'm going to treat you with something in just a moment, but
okay.
On our show, when they do call in, we give away these awesome t-shirts randomly to callers, so you'll see it's got our logo there, and it's got that phone number, so they can call in at 840-7260, that's the line, and 813 area code. But also, since we're streaming on the web, we also keep that on there. It's mhh.mysdhc.org, and they can find us on that website as well. We also do reruns, so I know, not only just a live show, but you do occasionally we'll catch the show running at other times, so you can call in. So Superintendent, we
yes.
decided that you needed to do the math as well, so
we are
providing you with a Do the Math t-shirt.
I love it.
I know you like to get out and advertise for
Absolutely.
Our district, so
Absolutely.
You can advertise for a TV show.
Well, thank you so much, Tammy. I really appreciate it. I'll be watching Thursday night.
Great.
Okay?
Great.
All right. Well, thank you so much for joining us. Everyone, we will be right back.
Well, I first came to University of Florida through a field trip through Avid programs, and there I fell in love with the campus. I don't know, it's just the sense when you feel that you would be involved into the campus. I like how the old structure, and I like the Gator, which is of Florida. First of all, I would say that University of Florida has a great medicines program. The College of Medicine and the Shane's Hospital is right across the street. That's why I want to go to Florida. The first friend I made was a Vietnamese friend, and she was an Avid student. And during lunch, I kind of like sneak out of my regular class, and I sat with the Avid class during lunch. And I don't know, they all wear the same type of shirt, and I kind of, they all have, I guess, the same goal. So they share something similar, and I found that sense of unity, all of that together, make who I am today, and kind of guide my way to college. And through Avid, I have a bigger picture. You know, tennis is kind of, when you play single, it's the game of the individual. So you have to determine where to take the shot, where to earn points. And for when I was a from seventh grade to freshman year, that's basically what I do. Like I was by myself, and I have to find a way to overcome my obstacle. So I see that in tennis. I came from a third world country. There were not any options. I just have to go to secondary school. So I thought that the Hillsborough education really promote the post-secondary school. That is definitely a big step to go to college, and knowing that you have a foundations, knowing that you have a step ahead, and you will be successful in college. My English wasn't that good at all. Like, I was nowhere near college level, and but she helped me. Like, we went over my essays in detail, sentence by sentence, see what I did wrong, what my vocabulary was, my sentence structure. So last year was a tough year, but she helped me out, grow as a writer, grow as a college student, grow as a scholar. She teach me how to think critically. I am lucky to have Ms. Mempo as a teacher and a mentor.
Just through sheer tenacity and hard work and dedication, she is going to be our valedictorian here at Lato High School, and she has a scholarship to the University of Florida.
My mom did not want me to go to University of Florida, but on February 12th, when I got the acceptance, like I called her on the phone, and I was like, "Mom, I got in. Like, I'm gonna go there." And she was so happy. I never seen her like that happy. So I guess it's real that I am, like, for her to sacrifice her life to go here, and I'm going to college. I'll have a future. That's a big deal.
Tran has something unique that you don't typically see in a high school student, and that's a curiosity and just a love of learning. So I think whatever Tran decides she wants to do, she will do it.
Hey, I want to do something good in life. I want my life to have a purpose. So I want to work with Doctor Without Border, and also because I always wanted to do something in medicine field. I see myself 10 years from now, I'll be working. I just like that, like what I said about Doctor Without Border. I will probably be applying or doing my first mission with them as a volunteer. I will still be learning about other culture and still appreciating the opportunity that I have coming to the United States.
Hello and welcome back. Recently, I had the opportunity to be part of the National Alliance of Black School Educators annual conference. Our local chapter was fortunate enough to take the lead in hosting this year's event right here in Tampa. NABCE was founded more than 35 years ago, and its main goal has remained the same: to partner with school districts throughout the United States in furthering the academic success of our nation's children, particularly those of African descent. Today, the organization has an outreach that touches more than 10,000 educators, including teachers, administrators, and superintendents. The conference was phenomenal. Let's watch a few clips from this amazing event.
Hey. we gather today and this week amongst fellow educators and colleagues, you have to know, as you look to your colleagues in every session of this conference, the superheroes are not out there somewhere. The superheroes for our kids are right in our schools every day. We are needed more than ever. Welcome to Tampa. Hope you enjoy your time here and enjoy this time.
As you know, the Superintendent Eakins is advocating for 90% of graduation rate in 2020. So this fits into the whole big picture of having all of our partners and Hillsborough County Schools and NAPSE are partners together in education. And so this is a great opportunity to show how we are advocating and promoting education for all students, but also for African-American students locally.
We have an opportunity here to bring educators from all over the world, have them all come together and really share ideas and best practices so that we can put together a system of service and be able to make sure that we are meeting the needs, the very diverse needs of all of our children.
Well, this particular conference really focuses on the education of our African-American students, which is such a dire need to focus on what it is that they need in order to succeed. But the beauty of the reason why it's so important of it being here in Tampa is for several reasons. First of all, we have a beautiful city, a beautiful county. Second of all, the weather is just phenomenal. And third of all, economic development. We are bringing folks to the Tampa Bay area. So I welcome all of the school board members and educators from throughout the nation to our city and to our district, and hopefully they can take a lot of what we're doing here in Hillsborough County back to their prospective districts.
And just really, you know, excited about this conference, excited about it being in Tampa. And it's important because as educators, when we get an opportunity to unify, to learn from each other, to collaborate and discuss those strategies and best practices for educating all students, but specifically for African-American students, we think it's important, we think it's necessary, and we're appreciative of Hillsborough County for supporting this effort.
The National Alliance for Black School Educators, first of all, this is the 44th annual conference. It's a big deal. I mean, obviously close to 1,000 educators from across the country. But if you think about everything that we're focused on in Hillsborough County right now, we're focused on equity. We're focused on success for all kids. And we're looking at the supports that every student is needed. This is really what this conference is all about, sharing strategies to support all students, specifically our African-American students who obviously have had some challenges academically, with our graduation rates, in the areas of discipline. You know, we want to have all the strategies for our teachers to utilize to be able to help them to be successful. So conferences like this bring all the great minds together to talk about those types of strategies.
I am honored that our county had the chance to be a part of this powerful conference. It was a great success. Well, I want to take a few moments to update you on a few developments from the past week. Two new board members joined us, and we have a new chair and vice chair. Let me take this opportunity to congratulate our new board members. Tamara Schamberger is the new board member for District 5. She is a Tampa native and a graduate of Bloomingdale High School. Lynn Gray is our new board member for the District 7 countywide seat. She served as a teacher and instructional leader in Hillsborough County for 26 years. Two of our board members, Cindy Stewart and Susan Valdez, were reelected to serve another term. Mrs. Valdez represents District 1, and Mrs. Stewart is District 3. Congratulations are also in order for Mrs. Stewart, who was elected as school board chair. Board member Sally Harris will serve as vice chair. I'm excited to continue a great relationship with the board as we prepare students for life. That's all the time we have today. Remember, I am always happy to answer any questions you have and encourage you to go to our district's intranet site and fill out our fact or fiction form. You can find a link to the form on the intranet homepage. I hope your break was a good one and that you are recharged and ready to finish out the semester. And don't forget to follow me on Twitter at Jeff_Eakins. I love hearing from you. Thank you for watching. Until next time.